class C type commutation. Here this is the basic circuit for the class C type commutation. Now here we are taking one SCR1 which is called main thyristor or SCR which is required to be turned off. Now this SCR1 is connected in series with the load resistance. That means that is our branch number 1. And another branch is consist of one resistance is connected in series with the SCR2. Now this SCR2 is the auxiliary thyristor or the SCR which is used to turn off the main thyristor. Now these two combinations are connected in parallel and it is connected across supply voltage E, or you can say VS. Now initially we assume that there is no charge available across this capacitor and the both thyristor or SCR, SCR1 and SCR2 are in off condition. Now let us see the working principle of this C-type commutation. Now first we apply gate pulse to the SCR1 which turn on the SCR1. So now in this figure showed when SCR1 is on, so that means there are two loops are available and two types of current are passing through this circuit. One current passing through this load resistance. Now the path of this current is from plus E to RL and it is passing through anode terminal, anode to cathode of SCR1, and then it is passing through minus E voltage, and this current is known as a load current. Now another current passing through this capacitor, that's why it is called charging current, and its paths provides paths plus E to R, one plate of capacitor, then another plate of capacitor, and SCR1 anode cathode and negative terminal of E. Now the total current passing through this battery or supply is equal to I is equal to IL plus IC. Now due to this capacitor is start to charge with right side plate is positive and left side plate is negative. Now capacitor is fully charged that means E voltage is available across this capacitor, that means your supply voltage. Now if I want to turn off this SCR1, that time SCR2 is triggered by applying gate pulse. So now as shown in this figure, when we are giving triggering pulse to the SCR and it is turned on, the positive plate of capacitor is connected to the cathode terminal of SCR1 or main SCR, and negative plate is connected across the anode terminal of the SCR1. So from that we can say that SCR1's getting anode having positive negative polarity supply and cathode having positive polarity of the supply. That means SCR1 is reverse bias. Now due to this reverse bias across this SCR1, which turn off the thyristor 1 or main thyristor. So from that we can say that SCR1 is turn off due to the SCR2. So now that time this current is passing through follow the path from E plus to RL, one plate of capacitor to the another plate of capacitor, then it is passing through SCR2 and E terminal of the battery. So now the capacitor is again start to charge, but it is in reverse polarity. So due to this, the right plate right side plate with right side plate negative and left side plate is positive. So now if I want to turn off this SCR2, then triggering pulse applied to the SCR1 which may turn on the SCR1. So the this positive plate is connected to the cathode terminal of SCR2 and negative terminal is connected to the anode of the SCR2. That means reverse voltage appear across this SCR2, which may turn off the SCR2. So from we can say that SCR1 is turned off by SCR2 and SCR2 is turned off by SCR1. So it is most important. Now this SCR1 and SCR2 both are turned off by the capacitor voltage. That's why it is called voltage type commutation, and it is used for 100,000 frequency in parallel inverter, and it is very reliable commutation for the SCR or